children, now we are going to see about simple future tense. That is, simple future tense, when we will use simple future tense, whenever we talk about the actions that will take place in the future, whenever we talk about any action that are going to take place, okay, which has not yet happened but going to happen, then in such case it is said as simple future tense. Okay, we use will or shall along with the base form of the verb. Okay, along with the base form of the verb, normally we will use will or shall. Okay, now where we will use will and shall? Generally we use shall with I and we. Generally, mostly we will use shall with I and we. Okay, but there are some exceptional places where we also use will with I and we. Mostly we will use shall only along with I and we, but there are some places, there are some exceptions. Okay, there are some exceptions where we will use will with I and we. Hope you are clear. And then we will use will with he, she, it, you, they, and along with all singular and plural nouns. For all singular and plural nouns, okay, we will use will. Okay, in order to form future tense, that is simple future tense, mostly we will use shall with I and we. But there are some exceptions. Sometimes we also use will with I and we. Okay, children? And when we will use will, we will use will with he, she, it, they, and you. Not only that, even for all singular and plural nouns, we will use will. But always have this in your mind. It is not that we will use only shall with I and we. Sometimes we also use will with I and we. Hope you are clear. Children, let us see exercise A. So they have asked us to make a tick mark if it is a simple future tense and put a cross mark if it is not a simple future tense. Okay. So read the sentence and you have to mark it tick if it is a simple future tense. If it is not a simple future tense, then you have to mark it cross. Okay. Now, listen here, the first one. I will go to the market tomorrow. How you will identify that it is a simple future tense? Very good. They have used will along with the base form of verb. So, this is a simple future tense. So, they have marked tick. Dilip takes a nap in the afternoon every day. Nap means sleep. Dilip takes a nap in the afternoon every day. Is there any will or shall? No. Okay. So, this is not a simple future tense. So, you have to mark it as cross. Okay. Similarly, you have to do the rest. Now, look at the exercise B. Rewrite these sentences using the simple future tense. One has been done for you. So, under this exercise B, either they would have given the sentence in simple present tense or present continuous or past tense, where they are asking us to rewrite it in the simple future tense. Okay. Now look at here. I sleep in the afternoon. So this is simple present tense. I sleep in the afternoon. They have asked us to convert the simple present tense into the future tense. I will sleep in the afternoon. Okay. I told you, in some places you will use will with I and we. Okay. Now look at the second one. The dog follows its master home. The dog follows its master home. Now you have to convert the simple present tense into the simple future tense. So the dog will follow its master home. So all you have to do is you have to add will before follow and you have to remove the s. Hope you are clear. Yes. Similarly, you have to do the rest on your own. So children, look at the exercise C. You have a holiday on Saturday. Write down any 8 things that you plan to do that day. Okay, so you have to write down any 8 things. okay, using the simple future tense. Yes, so what and all you have planned to do on that particular day, okay ma? So I will wake up early and go jogging, and then what you will do? I will bathe, like that. I will play with my friends, or I will have my breakfast, like that. You have to write 8 sentences using simple future tense, okay, about your own plan that you have planned to do on that particular day, okay? Yes.